So, hello everyone. So I really welcome Mr. Venkatraman Kavidikeri, who secured rank 363 in the Civil Services Examination 2019. And now I would like to ask Mr. Venkat to please share your journey. And you cleared this examination in the fifth attempt, which is a unique thing. I mean, this is not an easy thing. So can you please share the highlights of your journey and what kept you motivated and going for such a long time?
Yeah, Rahul, it was a bit long journey. I started my preparation in 2015 and I left the well-paying corporate job. It was a dream job for all electronics engineers, a chip design engineer in a reputed MNC. So I left that and started my preparation. But I gave two attempts. I could not clear the final journey. So at the same time, I got the opportunity of becoming a probationary officer in State Bank of India. So I grabbed that opportunity and worked because it was an exciting journey as well. I could help a lot of people, including farmers. And so that actually kept me motivated throughout a long journey. It was though long journey, but I feel it is worth it now after getting selected.
Yeah. So the biggest problem nowadays is that, it's not as of now. I mean, it's a problem with many people that the journey is so long. It takes 1.5 year minimum if you are in the first attempt, and it might take maybe 3, 4, 5 years. So how to manage the preparation? Because as we move to the next year, the more material we have, more complex becomes the preparation.
Yeah, I agree with it, because a UPSC examination is an evolving examination. You can see it through 2013 question paper and 2020 prelims question paper, as well as mains question papers of previous years. It has been continuously evolving and UPSC is increasing the difficulty level day by day. So that means that once you do preparation in 2015 or 16, you cannot sit quiet and say my preparation is over and I'm going to write the exam again and again, I will clear it. You have to adapt to the evolving situation of the examination. So how paper setter is thinking and how the question papers are being framed by UPSC and what qualities it is trying to test over the period of time. So it is undergoing a huge change under this LPG era, which we are witnessing in our country. So we have to adapt to this change. So in that process, what I actually used to do is I regularly used to follow current affairs materials. But this is a sine qua non, reading a particular one or two newspapers, for example, The Hindu or Indian Express. Apart from that, what we call as a static book, for example, for quality, there is Lakshmikant, environment, there is Shankar IAS, and for history, there is Bipin Chandra or Spectrum or Sekar Bandopadhyay, or for ancient and medieval history, there is old NCRT, new NCRT, etc. And economics, there are materials like Ramesh Singh, Sriram Economy, IAS material, etc. So one point I want to highlight by seeing the question paper of 2020 prelims. UPSC has beaten all institutes as well as standard texts, what we call. Almost all questions are being prepared from unconventional sources. So let us talk about this in later part, because this is an interesting observation I have made. I will explain it to you very clearly.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that is the next question that I am having actually. This 2020 prelims, on the surface, it seems to be like very difficult. But if someone has really grounded himself into the concept, then he or she is getting very good marks. So how is this contrast? What is your observation about that?
So the thing is, what UPSC did in 2020 prelims paper is, they went through earlier articles. Like for example, for 2020, they have asked questions from 2016, 17, 18 current affairs. And in some questions, I have observed, for example, ocean mean temperature. What they did is they picked the particular keyword from a Hindu article and they went to original research paper by that person. That professor had done some research and they went to original article of that professor and picked two statements and made question. So such unique things they have done this time. But the thing is, there is a possibility of doing well in the such paper. But problem is, it will depend on your luck because you have to take calculated risk in such papers. So hence, people are able to score well in even such papers, difficulty level when increased by UPSC.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. And what is your what strategy did you use, or what should be the best strategy to prepare for the GS mains? Because in the prelims, we know the score on the day one, but in the mains, we don't know the score till our result is actually declared. And it's a big dilemma. Should we go for the content? Should we go for the answer writing? Answer writing should be daily answer writing, or should it be full length test? I mean, there is so much to think and so much to do in the mains examination. And as you know, next 3 months are devoted for the mains only. So what can be the best way to prepare for the mains?
See, I will define prelims and mains in two terms. Prelims is an examination for rejection. Mains is an examination for selection. You can observe the differences between the two papers, what UPSC is doing. In main examination, UPSC is asking questions from popular themes. They're repeatedly asking question on inclusive growth every year. There is question on sustainable development every year. There is question on Panchayat Raj institutions every year. There is question on conflict of interest every year. You can see question paper and observe the trend. UPSC doesn't want to give something from falling from the sky on your head on the day of examination and you could not write anything. That will not test anything. So UPSC wants people to write well in the examination so that they can test their analytical ability, critical thinking, as well as powers of assimilation, as well as grasp of the subject, conceptual clarity. So these factors will come into picture in main examination. So study for preliminary examination and main examination differs in this basis. So for main examination, which is going to happen in next 3 months, is going to have a unique, different kind of paper compared to prelims paper. UPSC will ask questions on popular themes, which are current affairs, which are in news. So such questions are being asked. So prepare them well. Try to give justifications through examples, case studies, flowcharts, diagrams, as well as make answers, beautify your answers, make it diversified. Don't go on writing in paragraphs or story format. You have to show that you are an intellectual. Use the quotations of experts. Use the definitions of standard institutions. For example, last year there was a question on inclusive growth. I use a standard definition of UNDP, United Nations Development Programme's inclusive growth definition. When they asked something on sustainable development, I used a definition of Brundtland Commission, what it said for sustainable development. When they ask something on disaster management, define it through NDMA Act or some UNSDIR. There is a United Nations Institute. So such, for example, good governance, you can use definition by World Bank. So such unique things will make your answer stand apart from others. That gives an edge. So you should do work on these things instead of reading n number of materials given by coaching institutes. There will be flooding of current affairs, booklets, etc. in next 3 months. It will not serve any purpose. Read static part very well and complement it with popular current affairs. For example, in 2017, there was an issue of right to privacy, GST. UPSC asked question on them. Last year, there was issue on NIA, UAPA, National Investigation Agency and Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, etc. So they ask question on them. They do not deviate from such trend. So you have to prepare well-known things. When there will be some questions which people will not know. For example, last year there was a question on Cyberdome project. It is common to all. If you do not know it, other person who is writing exam also do not know it. Your assessment will not happen on the basis of such questions. your assessment happens on questions where everyone is able to write and everyone able to present themselves well. So there, how much difference you make compared to others will determine your stand in the list.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, you have touched very good dimensions. Rather than running for more material, the student must go for the authentic material, the relevant things, and they should always look for the definitions, the facts, the quotations from the authentic sources. And that is a key, actually. Wonderful. And what is your take on writing daily answer or attempting full test? Should it be like mix of both? And what are the benefits of each of them?
For example, about answer writing practice, I used to follow certain strategies. I do not read or I do not write answer writing. I do not practice it every day. The thing is, what I do is the compilation which comes from popular institutes. I try to identify important questions or themes which are being repeated by UPSC. I try to identify them and I compile them and I read them. And if I feel that their material is insufficient, I will just go through some news articles related to them so that I can put more quality content in that. So that is my strategy. And I do practice answers, but not through in that such a daily manner. I write tests. For example, last year I subscribed to Vision IAS test series for main examination. What I did is I used to write two tests a day. Per day, two tests of just like what UPSC does. I wrote around 12 tests. And also I wrote four tests of Shankar IAS. There was practice of 20 tests for a GS. So that was my strategy. It could help me in bringing efficient time management and proper structuring of the answers, plus different diversified presentation, including facts, figures, diagrams, flowcharts, etc. So I will tell you clearly, those questions you will practice in main test series may not be repeated. You should not go on the hope that those questions will come in the exam. If it comes, you are a lucky person. But the aim of subscribing to test series should be on improving your qualitative aspects and improving that structural aspects of answers. So that should be the focus.
Absolutely. Thank you. Now, this current affair is also a big thing, and you touched few aspects of the current affairs. What should be the way out to manage the current affair in the minimum possible time, especially for the mains examination?
For example, the thing is, in covering current affairs, people read a standard newspaper, The Hindu, you know it very well. But the problem is, it is now not able to give balanced view in many issues. So this is frankly, I'm telling this. The Indian Express, which comes in North India, it doesn't come in South India. It covers articles in a well-balanced manner. It gives scope for all hues and spectrum in its op-ed pages. And explained page is very beautiful one. So I can say that The Hindu is mandatory, for example, because factual questions do come. I will tell you an example. Last year, what happened in GS3 paper, there was a question on Cyber Dome project. GS3, I want to repeat this. Actually, in The Hindu, an article came on the same day in the morning. There was an article on Cyber Dome project. You can go through Hindu website and you can see the date, 21st September. And we wrote GS3 paper on that day. Cyber Dome project was in news in that day. So such things are going to be a surprise gift for you in the examination by UPSC. So do The Hindu very well, but at the same time, complement it with the Indian Express. And apart from that, reading one financial newspaper like Economic Times or Live Mint or Business Standard. Actually, I prefer Business Standard. It covers a lot of issues in its op-ed pages. So at least three newspapers in a selective manner. I don't say you go on reading every article. because you should, when you have to be very careful in selecting articles. You cannot go on wasting the time. So, because that judgment will come to you when you mature in the preparation cycle.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So that is the approach which I used to follow, especially during interview. I used to read articles of multiple newspapers, especially op-ed pages.
Yeah.
To get diversified views.
Yeah. You said it right that this approach can be used only by the matured guys. Like beginners can't use it. Actually, they will really going away from the direction of the preparation. Anyways, I mean, this is something very good, and Business Standard actually gives very important topics, and the analysis is really good, especially on the policy issues. Thank you for mentioning that. So once the mains examination is over, how do aspirant should start preparing for the interview? I mean, what should be done for the interview?
In my UPSC journey, I have faced a UPSC interview for 4 times. I have seen ups and downs in the journey.
Experience you are carrying.
So, I would tell you, you just go through compilations of previous transcripts by toppers. Many people have shared their transcripts. It is available in Telegram or many other forums. So you can download them, take printout of them. They have been compiled by motivated people who want to help aspirants. So they have been compiled and you take printout of them. You have to identify trend of questions what UPSC members or boards are asking in an interview, because you can certainly decipher that trend. What I did this year is I compiled certain unique aspects of each members. If it is Bassi sir board or if it is Sujata ma'am board, how they ask questions, how they take forward the interview. For example, there was a repeated trend in Sujata ma'am board. She used to ask, introduce yourself with your educational qualification and your work experience. So do mention only those things when she is asking. Don't go on telling your hobbies, you want to become civil servant, etc., etc. So you have to answer in a manner where a member's mind is working. It is impossible to completely understand what they have in mind, because it is a human nature. We cannot go that. But thing is, you can see the trend. You can prepare, align your preparation in that direction. So that is first thing for understanding what could be asked. Second part is DAF preparation. So DAF preparation is an integral part of your preparation. Detailed application form, whatever you fill, go on asking. For example, in 2019 interview, last year, P.K. Joshi sir board took me and they asked me question on Sanskrit, because I had one subject as Sanskrit in 10th and 12th. So they asked me a question. And again, I will tell some we feel that it is minute aspect and they may not ask question. So, but it is not so. If UPSC member's mind comes across such question, unique thing, or he feels something to be asked in that, he will certainly ask. So don't leave anything in dark. Prepare certain set of questions. For example, diademy. It actually took my DAF and helped me. So you guys actually gave me some certain unique questions which can be asked in interview. It actually helped me a lot. I prepared some more questions based on them. So that is the second part, DAF preparation. Third aspect is about current affairs. So I told you mains preparation, you can follow two, three newspapers. But here it is now more giving more balanced judgment in interview. So for that, UPSC asked a lot of controversial questions also. It is not knowledge intensive. Interview is not knowledge intensive. Interview is about understanding your analysis, understanding your balance of judgment, critical power of assimilation. They have given factors on the basis of which a candidate will be assessed. It is clearly given in notification. There they say what are the factors we are going to test in the personality test. They call it as personality test, not even interview.
Absolutely.
So yeah, reading newspaper is very important aspect current for current affairs. Don't read compilations for interview. because compilations will not give you different perspectives, because one topic can be answered in multiple views. So taking balanced stand becomes very critical in such things. Otherwise, if you go on one-sided highway, you may be beaten, definitely, because the UPSC board is very balanced.
Absolutely. Thank you for really, comprehending this interview in three parts, about members of the UPSC, then about DAF, and then current affairs. I mean, this is the systematic preparation that you have done. And no doubt, like, that has given the result, which is there in front of us. So the last question is, what do you suggest, like, any three tips which really, I mean, you learned from your own experience, which if you would have learned in the starting of your preparation, then the journey would have been much easier. Any three things?
So I would tell you three important things which I could improve if I had understood the importance of these things in the beginning itself. First one is, I became too materialistic in my first or second attempts. You understand what materialistic I mean? Means collecting materials became hobby. So it is a problem for every aspirant. So only I understood that my room itself becoming library with lot of books, printouts, etc. So then I started avoiding. Then I started using soft copies. Then I started understanding how to selectively read things, collect things, and use them wisely in the answers. I have a quote for this. Knowledge is waste unless you use it properly. In this UPSC case, knowledge is waste unless you are using it in examination. So that should come to your mind. You have to keep it in an organized manner. You should be able to revise it whenever it is needed. So I could not maintain proper revision material in beginning. So I did the haphazard preparation. Actually, I had heaps of newspapers in my room of The Hindu. I had 2 years of The Hindu in my room.
That happens in the first couple of years of preparation.
Yeah, I didn't know how to do that. And actually, in next attempt, what I started doing is I started marking some 4 or 5 important articles a day. And I went to the website and searched for that article and took print of that article and saved it as PDF and started saving it in folders. So, and in the end of the month, what I used to do is I used to filter it again, because there will be a lot of repetition of articles, and articles in newspaper goes advancing as days progress. So, and because the news goes developing. So that will help you to eliminate the articles which are not relevant after the end of month. So that started helping me in making the preparation more organized. So that is one point. Second point, I told you how I read newspapers. Third is about understanding your strengths and weaknesses. So that is very important. So what I used to do is I knew that I can write well in main examination, but still I used to not practice answers. I did not take test series because I had kind of overconfidence. I felt I can write well. You know, in 2016 and 17 attempt, after preliminary examination, I directly wrote answers on UPSC booklets. Not a single answer writing practice.
Yeah.
But I avoided that in 2018 and fourth and fifth attempts. Actually, it helped me in all cumulative efforts helped me in fifth attempt. So that was a kind of progress I made. I could have written more answers in the beginning itself.
Absolutely. Thank you, Mr. Venkat, for sharing your wonderful journey. And the points which you shared are really practical. And if someone learns from your mistakes, I can say that maybe he or she will save a couple of years. So thank you for sharing your journey with us. And it's a privilege for me to be interacting with you. And thank you for giving your time. All the best from DIAT-MEIS.
Thank you for providing this opportunity to share my thoughts and my experience of this long journey, which ultimately ended in success. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.